Hello everyone, welcome back to Power BI 0 to Hero playlist. My name is Sandeep Rathuri. In this video, I will explain you what is data modeling in Power BI. Data modeling is the process of organizing your data into tables, defining relationships between them, and enhancing the data with calculated fields, measures, and hierarchies. In Power BI, data modeling is crucial because it helps Power BI understand how different tables relate to each other. For example, let's suppose you have multiple sources such as sales, customers, and products. So data modeling allows us to create a structure where all of these tables can work together to provide insights. Without a proper data model, Power BI would struggle to combine the data correctly and give you accurate reports. Let's talk now key components of data modeling. First one is tables. Tables hold your data. In Power BI, you can import tables from various sources like Excel, SQL Server, or cloud services. Each table can have multiple columns representing different fields. For example, you might have a customers table with columns for customer name, customer ID, country, and so on. In my previous videos, I explained import and direct query modes, showing how you can import data from Excel or SQL Server into Power BI desktop. You can check those videos for reference. Now I will show you the tables in Power BI desktop. Here you can see the list of tables under data tab, customers, date table, products, and sales transaction table. In customers table, we have three fields, country, customer ID, and customer name. And if you want to see the data for tables, you can check under table view. So here you can see the customers data. And if you want to see the products table data, so just select the products table, and this is the data for products table. Second component is primary and foreign keys. When creating relationships, one table should have a primary key, a unique identifier such as customer ID or product ID that uniquely identifies each row. The other table has a foreign key which refers to the primary key in the first table. Now I will show you the primary and foreign keys in the Power BI desktop. This is the products table, and the product ID column is the primary key because it contains unique IDs for each product. Go to the customers table and you can see that customer ID holds unique customer IDs for each customers. So customer ID is the primary key here. In the sales and transactions table, transaction ID is a primary key because it holds unique IDs, while customer ID and product ID are foreign keys linking to the customers and product tables. Now I will show you the relationship between tables under model view. So go to the model view. Here you can see customers table is connected with sales transaction table based on customer ID. So in customers table, customer ID is a primary key, and in sales transaction table, customer ID is a foreign key. Products table is connected with sales transaction table based on product ID. So in products table, product ID is a primary key, and in sales transaction table, product ID is a foreign key. Date table is connected with sales transaction table. So in date table, date column is a primary key, and in sales transaction table, transaction date is a foreign key. Third component is relationships. Relationships are at the core of data modeling. In Power BI, you define relationships between tables so that data can be combined for further analysis. Go to the Power BI desktop. Under model view, you can see the relationship between tables. And if you want to modify the existing relationship, just double click on the relationship line between two tables. It will open the edit relationship window. And from here, you can choose another column for relationship and just click on save button. And if you notice here, for sales transaction table and customers table, customer ID column is highlighted. That means relationship has created between both tables based on customer ID columns. Now I will explain you active inactive relationship. An active relationship is the default relationship that Power BI uses to filter data between two tables. When you create a relationship between two tables, it is typically set as active. Now I will show you the practical of active relationship. Under model view, you can see the relationship between tables. To show you the example, I'm going to delete existing relationship between customers and sales transaction table. So just select the relationship line between both tables, right click and click on delete, give your confirmation and click on yes. So relationship has been deleted between both tables. So from customers table, press and hold the customer ID and drag it into in sales transaction customer ID. It will open the new relationship window, and in bottom you can see the make this relationship active by default is checked. So that means whenever you create a relationship between two tables, by default relationship is set to active. An inactive relationship is a relationship that exists but is not currently being used to filter data. Go to the Power BI desktop. Between two tables, only one relationship can be active at a time. So you can see here, we have a relationship between products and sales transaction table based on product ID column. So now I will try to create one more relationship between products and sales transaction table. So just for an example, I am trying to create relationship based on product ID column from products table and transaction ID column from sales transaction table. So from products table, press and hold the product ID column and drag it into in sales transaction table transaction ID column. So it will open the new relationship window, and if you notice here in bottom, this time this option is not selected. So just click on save, and if you see here, second relationship has been created with dotted line. Dotted line indicate inactive relationship. And if you will try to make this relationship active, let's see what happened. Just double click on the relationship line and it will open the edit relationship window, and just select this option. So you can see here, it will give you the error, because between products and sales transaction table, we created two times relationship, and at a time one relationship can be active between two tables. Now question is, how we can handle inactive relationship? Inactive relationship can be activated using DEX function such as use relationship. So in Power BI we have use relationship DEX function. To using use relationship DEX function, we can active the inactive relationship. I will explain to you how we can use relationship DEX for inactive relationship when I will make a video on DEX. Fourth component is cardinality. In Power BI, cardinality refers to the type of relationship between two tables based on the uniqueness of values in the columns that are related. It defines how data from one table corresponds to data in another table. Cardinality is crucial for creating proper relationships between tables in a data model, which is fundamental for accurate data analysis and reporting. Types of cardinality in Power BI. There are four main types of cardinality in Power BI: one to many, many to one to one, and many to many. Now I will show you the cardinality types in Power BI desktop. Under model view, you can see the relationship between tables, and if you notice, between customers and sales transaction table, relationship type is one to many. So for customers table it is showing 1, and sales transaction table side it is showing star, which indicates to many. In customer tables we have unique records of customers, there is no duplicate data, that's the reason it is showing 1. In sales transaction table, one customer can place multiple orders, so that's the reason it is showing star, means in sales transaction table we have duplicate customer IDs, so that's the reason relationship type is one to many. Means in customer tables we have unique records, in sales transaction table one customer can repeat multiple times. So one to many and many to one, both relationship are same. Now I will show you how you can check the cardinality. So just double click on the relationship line, it will open the edit relationship window, and in bottom you can see the cardinality. Once you open the cardinality drop down, it will show you the relationship types: many to one, one to one, one to many, and many to many. So many to one and one to many, both are same. If you see here, in sales transaction table, as I already told you, customer's ID can be repeat because one customer can place multiple orders. So that's the reason sales transaction table side it is showing many. And in customers tables we have unique records of customers, there is no duplicate data, so customer table side it is showing 1. So many to one and one to many, both are same. Then we have one to one. You can see the relationship type between date table and sales transaction table is one to one, means in both tables we have unique date values. And if you see the relationship type between date table and sales transaction table, that is one to one, means in both tables we have unique date values. In futures, if dates are repeats in sales transaction table, then relationship type would be many to one or one to many. And last one, we have many to many. So in this type of relationship, multiple rows in one table can be related to multiple rows in another table. In Power BI, many to many relationships were introduced to handle scenarios where both tables contain duplicate values. Let's suppose you have two tables, and in both tables you have duplicate values, or we can say duplicate IDs, and based on that IDs you are creating relationship between both tables. So relationship type would be many to many, because in both tables IDs are repeating. Fifth component is cross filter direction. When creating relationships between tables, Power BI allows you to choose the direction in which filters can flow. This setting is crucial for determining how data is filtered across related tables in your reports. We have two types of cross filter directions in Power BI. First one is single direction, or we can say one way direction, and second is both directions, or we can say bi-directional. Let's understand what is single direction or one way cross filter direction in Power BI. In single direction cross filtering, filters applied to one table affect the related table in one direction only. Filters flow from the one dimension table to the many fact tables. And this is the default and most common setting for relationship in Power BI. Let's understand with an example. Go to the Power BI desktop, and here you can see the cross filter direction icon top of the relationship line. So this is a single arrow, means cross filter direction is set to the single, and it will flow from dimension table to fact table. So sales transaction table is a fact table and customers table is a dimension table. So how you check the cross filter direction? So just double click on the relationship line, and here in bottom you can see the cross filter direction is set to the single. So what does that mean? Go to the report page, and here we have two table visuals. In first table visuals, I only use customer table columns, you can see here, and in second table I only use sales transactions column. So cross filter direction is set to the single direction, means whatever value I will select from customers table, it will filter the fact table, which is sales transaction table. So let's suppose in customers table I select 101 customer ID. So you can see here sales transaction table has filtered. It is showing only 101 customer ID data. Now I am selecting 102 customer ID. So you can see here in sales transaction table, data is filtered based on my selected customer ID. Now to select sales transaction table data, and let's see customer table has filtered or not. So let's suppose in sales transaction table, I select 101 customer ID. So you can see here customer table data is not filtering, because cross filter direction is set to the single direction, which filter dimension table to the fact table. Second, we have both direction, or we can say bi-directional cross filtering. In bi-directional cross filtering, filters can flow in both directions between two related tables. So let's go to the Power BI desktop to understand this. So in model view, now I will change the cross filter direction from single to bi-directional. So just double click on the relationship line and select both cross filter direction and click on save. So now you can see here between customers and sales transaction table, cross filter direction icon has been changed. So now it is showing both directional. Go to the report page, and now I am selecting data from sales transaction table. So let's suppose I clicked on 103 ID. So you can see here customer table is now filtering. And in same way, if I will select any customer ID from customers table, so it will filter the sales transaction table, because now cross filter direction type is bi-directional. So it will filter both tables. So here you can see the use case of bi-directional cross filtering. Bi-directional cross filtering is a particularly useful in many-to-many relationships or when dealing with multiple fact tables. It allows more flexibility in slicing and dicing data across multiple tables. Sixth component is hierarchies in data modeling. In Power BI, hierarchies are a way to organize data into a structured format that allows user to drill down or roll up through different levels of data. Hierarchies enable better data analysis and visualization, particularly when dealing with categorical data that can be logically grouped. Let's understand the hierarchies with an example. So here you can see I have three levels of hierarchies data. First one is category, second is subcategory, and third is product name. So here category is top level of hierarchies and product name is low level of hierarchies. Because first we have categories, under categories we have subcategories, and under subcategories we have product. So this is the hierarchy sequence. So when you select any category, so it will filter the second level of hierarchy, which is subcategory, you can see here. And when you will select any subcategory, so it will filter the third level of hierarchy, which is product name. So if you are maintaining the hierarchies in your data, so you can easily filter the top level of hierarchy to the low level of hierarchy, and you can easily understand the complex data. Then you can do the further analysis. Now go back to the Power BI desktop. So here you can see I have two matrix visuals. So in first matrix visuals, I am using column from product table, and in product tables I have two level of hierarchies. First one is category and second is product name. And in value section I am using sales column from sales and transaction table. So in matrix visual by default it will show you the top level of hierarchy, which is category. So you can see here it is showing two categories. First one is accessories, second one is electronics. And when you expand the first level of category, so it will show you the second level of hierarchy, which is product name. In same way, if you expand the electronics category, so under electronics category it will show you the product name, which is second level of hierarchies. In second matrix visuals I am using column from date table, and here we have three level of hierarchies. First one is year, second is month, and third is day. And in values column I am using sales column from sales and transaction table. So by default in matrix visual it will show you the first level of hierarchy, which is year. And when you expand the first level of hierarchy, it will show you the second level of hierarchy, which is month. And when you expand the month, it will show you the low level of hierarchy, which is day. When you hover over the visual, it will show you the some icon top of visual. So first one icon is drill up. So what is use of drill up? So right now we have three level of hierarchies data in matrix visual. First one is year, second is month, and third is day. And if you want to see the only two level of hierarchies data, which are year and month, so just click on drill up. So it will show you the two level of hierarchies data. And if you want to see the only first level of hierarchies data, just click one more time on drill up. So it will show you the first level of hierarchies data in matrix visual. Working of remaining three icons, I will make a separate video on hierarchies. Then I will explain you each and everything in detail. Next we have calculate columns and measures. What is calculate columns? It is a new column that you created using a DAX formula, and it is added to an existing table in your data model. For example, creating a new column in date table for year and month together. Go to the Power BI desktop. In date table, I will add one new calculate column to get the year and month number together. Just right click on data set name, select new column, and here you can write the DAX formula to get the year and month number. We will use format DAX for this, and from date column we will get the year and month number. So just mention the date column name. So here date table is table name and date is column name. After that we will use comma, and from date column we want only year and month number. So for that we will mention the format. So for year we will mention the 4 times y, because we want 4 digit year, then hyphen, and for month we will mention double m. So it will return the 2 digit month number, and then close the bracket and change the column name. This is year month column, and click on commit. So you can see here under date table one new calculate column has been created with existing column. And if you want to see the result of this column, go to the table view and select the date table, and here you can see the year month. Second is measures. Measures are similar to calculate columns, but they perform dynamically calculation based on the user's interaction with the report. For example, calculating total sales. Now we will create one measure for sales transaction table to get the total sales. Right click on the dataset name, select the new measure, and here we will use some DAX function to get the total sales from sales column. Here sales transaction is a table name and sales is a column name. Then close the bracket, change the measure name, total sales, and click on commit. So you can see measure has been created under sales transaction table. Now we will check the measure value. So add one card visual in the report page and drag the measure into card visual. So you can see here it is showing the total sales. and also you can use that measure in any visual. So for example, I am using one more visual, which is cluster column chart. Now I want to see the product wise sales. So from products table, I will add the product name in x-axis, and in y-axis I will use measure. Now you can see here product wise sales. The main difference between calculate columns and measure is calculate column takes space in the Power BI data model, and measure does not take any space in the data model. It calculates result on the fly, means whenever you use measure in the visual, then it will call. Now I will discuss with you one of the most important data modeling component, which is star schema in data modeling. The star schema is one of the simplest and most commonly recommended approaches for organizing a data model in Power BI. It consists of a fact table at the center, which is surrounded by several dimension tables. These tables are directly related to the fact table, forming a star-like pattern. So let me show you the star schema. Go to the Power BI desktop. In model view, you can see the tables. So in center, we have fact table, which is sales transaction table, and fact table is connected with multiple dimension table, which are customers, products, and date table. So it look like a star. So that's the reason we call this star schema. So components of a star schema is fact table and dimension table. So what is fact table? This table stores transactional or event data such as sales, orders, or payments. It generally includes measures like a sales amount, quantity, and other numeric values that you want to analyze. In our example, sales transaction is the fact table containing data such as transaction ID, customer ID, product ID, transaction date, quantity, and sales amount. Let me show you the fact table in our data model. Go to the Power BI desktop. Under table view, select the sales transaction table. So you can see here, this is a sales transaction table, which is fact table, and it only stores the transactional data, numeric values, measures such as quantity and sales. And here you can perform the aggregation formula such as sum, count, max, min. So for example, if you want to calculate the total sales, so you can use the sum formula. If you want to count the total number of quantity, so you can use the count formula. So this is the use of fact table. You can perform the aggregations. Next we have dimension table. So these tables store descriptive information that provide context for the data in the fact table. Dimension table usually have a primary key that uniquely identify each record. Dimension table typically contain non-numeric data such as name, category, or dates. Go to the Power BI desktop. Under table view, select the customers table, and you can see the customers table data. Customers table is a dimension table, and dimension table store unique values. Data cannot be duplicate, and here we are storing the customer name and country. And if you notice in sales transaction table, which is fact table, so in sales transaction table we are only storing the customer ID, which is linked to customers dimension table. And if you open the products table, so in products table we are storing the information of products, and here we have unique ID of each product, and there is no duplicate data. So here we are storing information of product and categories and price. And if you go to the sales transaction table, so here we are only storing product ID, which is linked to the products table product ID. And if you see the date table, so in date table we have unique date. There is no duplicate data. Here we are storing date, year, month, and day. And in sales transaction table, there is transaction date, which is linked to the date table date column. The main difference between dimension and fact table is, in dimension table we only store the attributes information and data cannot be duplicate. In fact table we only store the IDs, numeric values, and measures or transaction information, and we create the relationship between dimension and fact table based on IDs to get the information from dimension table. That's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more great content. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.